Here we have PanzerFausts and same hex fire examples on page 27 of the Decision at Elst rulebook. The T-34-85, we'll just call it a T-34, begins the movement phase by expending one movement point to start. The 467 and Z1 makes the PanzerFaust attempt, needing a final die roll of 3. No die roll modifiers apply if this is before 1945. When the German rolls a 4, the squad does not secure a PanzerFaust, but it's considered to have used a support weapon. It can still use its inherent or fire another support weapon. The 467 cannot try again until the AFV expends another movement point. The 548 makes a PanzerFaust attempt, rolls a 6, fails to secure a PanzerFaust, and is pinned. The tank expends another movement point to move to Y2. The pinned 548 makes another PanzerFaust attempt, rolls a 6, and breaks. Lucky him. The T-34 then enters Z1 at 1/2 of its movement point allowance of 8 MP for the cost of the building, and takes the required bog check for entering a building. It will bog on a final dice roll of 12 or more, and the dice roll modifiers are +1 for normal ground pressure, +3 for entering the wooden building. Russian rolls a 7, passes the morale bog check. The 467 then says, I'm going to make a second PanzerFaust attempt, and rolls a 3. Gets the PanzerFaust. At a range of 0, the PanzerFaust has a digit of 10. The applicable dice roll modifiers are +2 for TEM, because now he's in the building, +2 for moving vehicle, and possibly +2 for avoiding the back blast caused by firing from a building. The German declares that he will accept the back blast desperation penalty, therefore not having to get the +2. However, so the total is +4, and he rolls a 6 color die roll of 3. Hitting the AFV in the hull, colored die roll is equal to the white die roll. And in the side, colored die roll of 3 or 4 when shooting in the same hex. So lots of things are happening here. Hit it in the hull, hit it in the side. A 3 on the 1 firepower column results in a 1 morale check on the 467 as a result of the back blast, which, a later dice roll, the squad passes. Being marked with the first fire counter and having used 2 support weapons on the heat to kill table, the PanzerFaust has a small to kill number of 31. Yes, 31. It's not dyslexic, not 13, 31. Subtracting out the side hull armor factor of 6, yeah, good luck, results in a final to kill of 25. Only a dice roll of 12, a dud, can save the T-34. German rolls a 12. Leaving the T-34 unaffected. 467 cannot make any more PanzerFaust attempts, but it can attack the T-34 again since it spent 8 movement points to enter. The 467 now decides to conduct a close combat reaction fire attack against the tank and first takes a PAATC, pre-AFE attack task check. Passes it by rolling less than an 8, which is 7 morale. It has to roll 7 or less. The squad's normal close combat value of 5 is reduced by 1 to 4 for having already fired. And there's a +2 dice roll modifier since the vehicle is non-stopped. It has not expended a stop movement point. The German must roll a 2 to have any effect. If he did roll a 2 in close combat, the 467 would be eligible for leader creation. The German rolls higher than a 2, leaving the T-34 unaffected, but marking the 467 with a final fire counter. The T-34 then expends a movement point to stop, and the 467 makes another close combat reaction fire attack, this time as final protective fire. He could have done so before the T-34 stopped. The squad does not have to take another PAFV task check, and now there are no dice roll modifiers since the tank is now stopped, although the squad's close combat value is still reduced to 4 for having fired already. The squad rolls a 5, passes a final protective fire morale check, but with no effect on the T-34. Now the tank attacks the 467 on the 8 firepower column with +2 modifiers. The 6 firepower of the combined machine guns, 2 and 4, are tripled and halved from bounding fire. Because the tank only spent 1 movement point to stop, the squad cannot attempt another FPF close combat reaction fire attack before the T-34 gets to attack. If the tank had not stopped, its final power would be halved again for being non-stopped. The Russian rolls a 7, which becomes a 9 on the 8 for a pin task check. The German rolls a 10 and fails the pin task check, however becoming pinned. When he's pinned, this prevents any further close combat reaction fire. T-34 still has 5 movement points remaining. It could spend those as delay and end its movement phase in Z1, or it could start up again and exit Z1. If it stays in the hex, it will engage in close combat with the 4-6-7 again during the close combat phase, with no pre-AFV task check required. If both then survive the close combat phase, the 4-6-7, not the tank, would be locked in melee. The AFV would not, but would be precluded from firing outside the hex as long as the 4-6-7 was there. So lots of things going on with tanks in close combat. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.